Okay, good morning. Once again, we are back in the class of physical education. Yesterday we were dealing with OCD. What was OCD? Obsessive compulsive disorder. So we have done what was the symptoms. What are the various symptoms by which we can come to know this person is having something from the particular. And what are they? Okay, checking the logs again and again. Talking and talking again and again. Okay, then talking to him once and again and again. So these were some of the symptoms. Just a quick review of the symptoms. He was saying critically about that. He was what he told that what he also thought about cleanness. He will again and again wash his hands. After it comes, he is overly conscious about arranging the things. The things are arranged properly, then also he tried to adjust the things. Arrange the things again and again. After that comes repeated action of checking. The door is locked, there is a lock, but then also he will go in and out. So, repeated consciousness of checking. After that comes performing superstitious actions. Superstition, performing superstitious actions repeatedly and getting relief after performing. Once you perform, then you are getting relief. We know that it is wrong, but he doesn't know. He is more interested in performing the superstitious actions. So, what are the causes? Generally, research has not been able to find out what the general cause. But again, the reason comes genetics of the environmental factors. The causes of OCD is not known. But researchers follow believe that genetics and environmental factors may contribute. Genetics and environmental factors may contribute OCD. Some other factors which may contribute to OCD are behavioral aggression, depression, anxiety, instability, emotional instability, when the person is not very stable, when anxiety too much, depression, etc. That can lead to opposition, anxiety or depression, aggression. Symptoms start to show being in adolescence. Symptoms of OCD start going ahead when we start seeing them at the time of adolescence. And what will happen, they will strengthen over time. As the time passes, they will become strong, causing more stress. Now, we are dealing with all the disorders. Now, last topic, what is remaining in our disability and ED. Disability attitudes. Generally, what is that? What is acceptable behavior in the society? Acceptable. Something falls. Something. Some. Yes, because of what? What is? Sorry. Because of you, somebody has lost something. Because of you, somebody has got harm. What is the ultimate word we say? Sorry. Somebody has done something for us, what do we say? Thank you. So these are the attitudes we learn. Acceptable behavior. What is the acceptable behavior in the society that is known? Now we are dealing with the disability. So after I'll tell you what is disability attitudes. The word attitudes itself means acceptable behavior in the society. With good manners and code of conduct. With good manners, suppose you are forced to say thank you, you are forced to say sorry. That is not your attitude. That is accepted by the society, you say sorry, but not from some external force, some external warning you are saying that word, that is of no use. So acceptable behavior in the society with good manners and world code of conduct. This disability etiquette does not have separate code of conduct. It is simply the way in which you can make a person with special needs comfortable in their own world. When you are making the person with special needs, okay, children with special needs, you are making him comfortable in his own world. That disability is for the person. But we are dealing with the children with special needs. Those who are in disability, we are dealing with them. What to deal with them and how to deal with them and what are the manners in which you can deal. There are well good suggestions also that they are the activities, these are the activities inculcated inside you. So what other since every person is different, but different feeling. Or is her life will be different. Okay. People with different kinds of impairment will certainly have a different kind of mind. People with different impairment, different disability will have a different kind of mindset. Like those who are active, aggressive, some are emotions unstable. So you are dealing according to them. You are making yourself like that, and you are dealing with them. That means that the education inside you. So some common disability. The first type is showing disability is the use of language. Terms such as handicap, retarded, physical etc. are outdated and should not be used while addressing disabilities. Okay. Yeah. The terms such as handicap, retarded, even if it's bigger and mentally targeted, for example. After that comes psycho, confident, mental, challenged, abnormal. Such type of words should not be used when you are dealing with such people. Such type of words, what happens? You are giving an impression to that person also plus schools back. Saying these words, what is the first thinking in the mind, he doesn't have any activities. So these words are outdated, and we should not. Why we are using children with special needs? We are not using Viklang, Mentally Retarded, or that. These are the special needs. Because these are the activities we should have. Such people. Okay, rather we should use person with blindness. Blind person. Impaired person, disabled person, okay, handicap is Viklang, okay, but that is not a good word, that doesn't suit. So what is okay? What you call disabled person? Now you are, what is, meaning is same, but the way you have said, you have changed that, and that is the case. Yes, you have changed the way of saying, and by which you have said. If you are saying thank you forcefully, thank you, it is not acceptable. If you are saying by smiling or other, it is acceptable. Sorry. Yeah. For example, forcefully, sorry. That person is going to that some external force, because some external pressure you are saying. But sorry, with love, you are smiling, if you are saying that these are the attitudes, and that person is going to know you are a good person. After that comes the tone of our voice. The tone of our voice and our manners are just as important as the words we use. Tone is more important when you are talking to someone. What is important? Tone and the words. Tone and the tone of our voice and the manner while speaking are also important. And the manner while speaking are also important while speaking to someone else. We should speak as normally as possible, and over and being polite. And what is important? Being polite to that particular person. Even if the differently able person has an interpreter with them, we should speak directly to them. Generally, what happens when we are talking to a differently able person, generally they have an interpreter. Will make them understand. But it is better that we should not talk directly to them. We should directly talk to them. person himself who that said that person has something disability. After that, her point was we should not use sign language. We should not use sign language. A handshake will do just fine as a hand. We should not use okay from far away or shake hand. That will do just as like as that of people. We should ask two persons with speech impairment. Generally, what happens? First, there is speech impairment. If you are asking no questions to them, what will they ask? They will not be able to understand it. They will not be able to understand it. And it will be a big difficulty making you understand. And there is difficulty making you understand the same answer. So, what is important? You should ask short questions to persons with speech impairment rather than long explanations. We should also listen patiently without correcting them. What is important? We are going to listen. But with the people of general station, patiently and not speaking between. We should after people who use wheels or crutches, we should keep ourselves at the eye level. Generally, what happens? A person is on the wheel. He is not able to get up. What will happen? We are standing. So we are looking down towards him. No. You should come to his eye contact level. You should come to his eye contact level and take it. That gives us good feeling about you and about you, and these are the etiquettes. So when talking to people who use wheelchairs, we should keep ourselves at eye level and should not look down at what is important. Okay, while introducing ourselves, visual impairment, we should identify ourselves and others who are with us. Visual impairment generally is blinding. So introduce ourselves and others also. That will be a big help to that particular person. That will be a big help to that particular person. Rather than talk anything about here and there, you introduce yourself. Don't let him introduce about you. Introduce yourself. You are helping that particular person. In order to get the attention of a person with impairment, you should tap them on the shoulder and look them directly. Those who have a problem with the ear, those who have hearing impairment, you should have a tap on their shoulder and you should talk to them directly. They are having a problem. Okay. We should not ask differently personal questions. Most important, you should not ask personal questions to them. You should not ask personal questions to them unless they are open with you. They are open up with mark. Ask personal questions to the different persons. Okay. And after that, we should give differently able person additional time. Communicate what they wish without losing what happened. What we have learned till now, we should be able to listen to them properly. And we should not speak in between. We should give them ample of effort because we know that they are having difficulty communicating with us. So we should give them ample time in communication, so that they will feel happy. And once they are giving ample time to communicate, what will happen? Ample time is okay. He is communicating to you, but in between don't speak. In between don't speak. Be patient in listening. Listen to that particular person quietly. That is more important. You can make him happy. You can make him happy by being a listener also. Every time you can't be a, sometimes we are listener also. That plays a big role. So we should give differently able person additional time to communicate what they wish without losing our patience, without losing our patience. We know that it is very hard for them to communicate to us what they want to tell, what they want to communicate. It is very difficult for them. But then also we should give them time. We should give them time, and we should not lose our patience. What is important? We should not lose our patience. If we don't understand what their language is, we should not pretend to understand what is important. If they are having, they are also having, they also understand what they want to say. But if we are not able to understand, we are not able to understand what they are saying. Don't pretend that we have understood. Don't pretend that we have understood. Okay, may the repeat again not come up, but don't give them false promise. Okay, we have understood it and we are ready. Don't give them false. So last word, we should give effective able person additional time to communicate what they wish without losing our patience. After that, if we don't understand what they are trying to say, we should not pretend to understand. Okay, these were the activities. What is the meaning of acceptable behavior in the society? Acceptable behavior in the society. With good manners and that follow a code of conduct. That means etiquette. But when you are dealing with people with special needs, some are hearing, how to deal with them? You should have that manners and do them patiently. Okay, then suppose those who are on the beaches, don't push them and talk to them. Don't make them look inferior, okay. Don't look and make them inferior that you are standing and down. It is better you also come to the same level, have eye contact with them. Once you have eye contact, they will feel more happy and they will be, they can say more and more to you. But if you are looking like a boss, if you are standing in the room, it gives some negative effect about you. So what they will say, he is thinking more, he is thinking more about himself. I am not able to go, but he is able to go. He is thinking more about himself. There should not be any negative. These are the activities that should be inside you. So today we are done with the course of physical education. What will be the board explanation? On Monday, again, we will start with the revision. Now, all the disabilities as well as disorders we are done. Then, what are the disorders? ADHD, after that, comes SPD, ASD, ODD, and OCD. These disorders we are done. Disabilities we are done. What are the symptoms and what are the causes of different disabilities? Last topic was disability activities. So we are done with the course of physical education class for the class 12. Physical education course is over. If you are in doubt, okay, welcome. And also, now next class we will start again. Chapter on what is more like different types of cross, being cross. That is more important. I mean, in the board exam. So we are done with the course of physical education. All the topics which has been removed, we are not done. But all the topics that will be coming in the board examination, we are done. From Monday onwards, we will be starting the revision. And what is pending is already done, but what is important about it now. Okay, dear students, take care, be safe. Meeting you in our next class. Okay. With the, we will be doing the revision of planning in schools. Okay, dear students, take care.